expect rain-wise coming up in about 10 minutes. Guys, back over to you.
See you then, Anthony. Thank you. Back in June, Augusta Commissioners approved $700,000 for the Riverwalk. And just a few weeks ago, they tacked on another $90,000.
News 12's Hallie Turner spoke with an Augusta Commissioner to find out how they'll spend all that money.
The Augusta Riverwalk has been top of the list for debate for commissioners over the years. How much funding is needed for safety, cameras, and most recently, the upkeep?
This is such a beautiful asset for the city, and to see it neglected is really tragic.
Longtime Augustan Kevin DeLagle says the Riverwalk he enjoyed playing on as a child is almost unrecognizable.
Paving stones that are jacked up, weeds, and also trees that have fallen into the river, plantings that are neglected, the erosion, all of that. It's really gone down, and it's sad because this is sort of the front stoop, the front steps of Augusta.
In June, commissioners approved a total of $1 million to revitalize the Riverwalk. $700,000 of that ARP funding went strictly to make improvements to the Riverwalk.
Rights and improvements, and it's going to take that to do it.
The report shows repairs such as electrical infrastructure, safety issues, hazardous conditions, and more are needed. But Kevin said without more upkeep funding, the park will only look good during special occasions.
Man was happening, and it was looking really spiffy, and a Masters weekend looked spiffy, but we've got to get it to be a 12-month, 24/7 thing, get this cycle going, so that it's not just Masters, it's not just Ironman, it's not just Arts in the Heart, but that Augusta's nice and clean and trim looking to be the garden city that it's known for.
In November, commissioners went back and approved $90,000 more for the 2022 budget, something McKnight says is desperately needed.
You know, a lot of people might say, oh, that's too much money, but yet then you got others who are saying it looks so bad, so damned if you do it, damned if you don't, but you got to have money, this kind of money, to put towards upgrades and improvements.
We have reached out multiple times this week to Augusta Park and Rec Director Maurice McDowell for the breakdown on how they plan to spend that money and the most recent $90,000 and what it will look like for upkeep, but we've yet to hear back.
All right, thanks for that, Hallie. The body of a 14-year-old boy was discovered in a South Carolina hotel room on Monday night, but police estimate he's been dead for a week before anyone called authorities. According to a relative, the boy's mother was also in the hotel room, and she's now in the ICU, although we don't know why or the circumstances. According to the Greenville County Coroner's Office, the body of Landon Poston was found at In-Town Suites in Greenville.
One person dead, multiple others injured after a man crashes into a Wendy's in South Carolina. This was yesterday at a Wendy's in Hartsville, where a man crashed through the front doors, pushing the counter back all the way into the grill. One person pinned underneath that car in the corner, confirming a 70-year-old woman who was sitting inside the restaurant. She was hit and killed in that accident.
The Georgia Supreme Court has reinstated the state abortion ban. It's a little bit like whiplash. The court announced that ruling earlier this morning. The ruling took effect immediately statewide, but the state attorney general's office said they had filed an appeal. A previous court had ruled the law was void from the start since it was unconstitutional at the time it went into place. Doctors and advocates are asking the state court to permanently block the law.
The Georgia Supreme Court denying